Welcome to my channel Question Bank. This is the part 1 for second paper of Assistant Executive Engineer previous year paper 2015 conducted by OPSC. And in this video I have completed first 25 questions, and let's have the first question. First one is, in hydropower stations, an enlarged body of water just above the intake and used to regulate the reservoir is called, this is four-way. This is temporary storing to meet the hourly loads. Next question, which one of the following fuel is used by the slow thermal nuclear reactor for power generation? For this one, slow can be used uranium 235, and these two are uranium 238 and thorium 232 are for fast, and this is used also for slow, and as this is not popular, so this is the answer. Most accurate answer will be uranium 235, and including this one, uranium 233 also used for slow. Next question, when is the Ferrant effect on long overhead line experienced? This is, the line is lightly loaded. In Ferrant effect, the voltage is greater, the receiving end voltage will be greater than the sending end voltage due to this effect. Next question, the main criterion for selection of the size of a distribution for a radial distribution system. The radial distribution system, is generally selected for the voltage drop generally. Next question, a graphical representation of the discharge and time is known as, this is hydrograph. Question number 6, bundled conductor are mainly used in high voltage overhead transmission line, to reduce corona. Next question, the ring main distribution is preferred a radial system because, this is, voltage drop in the feeder is less and supply is more reliable. This is the preferred answer. Question number 8, the per unit value of a 4 ohm resistor at 100 MVA base and 10 kV base voltage is, this is, can be calculated. First we have to calculate the Z base, that is impedance base, which is kV square by MVA, and here kV is given 10 kV and MVA is given 100 MVA. Hence this is coming to be 1 ohm, and as base is 1 ohm, Z per unit equal to actual value by base value, which is equal to 4 per unit, and option B will be correct answer. Question number 9, the SLG single line to ground fault current is, the faulted phase is, SLG fault current is given that 300 ampere, the zero sequence current will be how much? This will be simply 300 ampere by 3, which is equal to 100 ampere. Option C. Next question. Zero sequence current does not exist in following. This is LL fault. In the fault in which ground is not included, then zero sequence current will not be present. Simply can be said that. Next question 11. For a fault in a power system, the term critical clearing time is related to reactive power limit, transient stability limit, short circuit current limit, steady state stability limit. This is transient stability limit will be the correct answer. Next, the load frequency control is achieved by properly matching the individual machines. This is turbine inputs. For two machine system, generally turbine inputs are matched for load frequency control. Next question. Question number 13. A power station has installed capacity 300 megawatt. Its capacity factor is 50% and its load factor is 75%. Its maximum demand is how much? We know that capacity factor is maximum load into load factor by plant capacity. This is the formula. And we have to find out the maximum load. And all the values are given. Hence, maximum load is coming to be 200 megawatt. Option C is the correct answer. Question number 14. If the fault current is 3000 ampere for a relay with a plug setting of 50% and CT ratio of 1000:1, the plug setting multiplier would be, the plug setting multiplier formula is fault current by current setting into CT ratio. Sometimes in denominator also the CT secondary current is remain, because if the CT ratio is given in a reduced form. And now we can calculate simply 3000 by 50 by 100. 50 by 100 means the 50% into 1000, and this is coming to be 6. Option D is the correct answer. Next question. A negative sequence relay is commonly used to protect an alternator. In thermal plants, the steam energy is converted into mechanical energy by means of steam turbine. Next question. The rotor used in alternator of hydroelectric station is cylindrical rotor, salient type rotor, non-salient pole rotor and round rotor with AC excitation. This is salient type of rotor. The fuel used in nuclear power station is uranium. Effect of water hammer is reduced by using surge tank. In an interconnected grid system, the diversity factor of the whole system increases. A uniformly loaded DC distributor is fed at both ends with equal voltages as compared to similar distributor fed at one end only. The drop at the midpoint. This is uniformly loaded here given uniformly loaded DC distributor. How this is? Suppose this is the distributor, here are the loads, and here is one source, here is another source. For first one, equal voltages both end. Here is volt V, here is V, and here are the loads, and smaller, 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 and the whole, and the if we completely say it, we can say that the total current entering at the same end, we can source end, we can say the current is I, overall current, and total resistance due to the loads, we can say R. And for the first case, that is uniformly loaded DC distributor fed at both end, at midpoint the maximum voltage drop will be, you can find it as 1 by 8 I into R. I have told what is I and R. Then in same case, distributor fed at only one end, means this is the line and here only the source, and here are the loads, and in this case this is half IR. Hence this becomes, here it becomes 1/4, here becomes 1/4, not here, here it becomes 4 times. You can find it in the section of DC distributor and DC distributor and uniformly loaded line. You can find all these calculations. Next question 22. Which circuit breaker is preferred for the interruption of high voltage and low current? Oil circuit breaker, air blast, vacuum, all of the above. This is air blast circuit breaker, but currently air blast circuit breakers are not used. Only somewhere, some old grids, you can find air blast circuit breaker. Now these are replaced by SF6 circuit breakers. Next question. Reactance relay is normally preferred for protection against, this is the earth fault, because reactance relay is not affected by variable impedances. Earth fault is generally associated with variable impedances, which is not affect, generally not affects the reactance relay. Hence reactance relay is most preferred for earth fault. Next question. Which relay is used to detect and protect internal faults of a transformer? This is Bucher's relay. Next question. The inductance of a power transmission line increases with, option A, decrease in line length, increase in diameter of conductor, increase in spacing between the phase conductors, increase in load current carried by the conductors. Here the inductance can be given as general formula is 2 into 10 to the power 7 ln GMD by GMR. GMD by GMR. And if we increase GMD or decrease GMR, then the whole term ln, that will increase, and in term L will increase. Given that transmission line inductance will increase, hence we have to increase GMD or decrease GMR. If GMR is increased, then L will decrease. Hence, we can say that GMD can be increased by increasing the spacing between the conductors. If we consider a single phase transmission line, two-way transmission line, then the formula becomes 4 × 10⁻⁷ from previous question this is 2 × 10⁻⁷, not simply 7, ln d by r1 dash r2 dash root over, and here d is the spacing between conductors, r1 is the effective radius of conductor, first conductor, and this is the second conductor, and here d is the spacing between the conductors. If we increase d, that is spacing between the phase conductors, then it will increase, inductance will increase. Hence, option C is the correct answer. This is the last question, and from this video I will post a simple question and I will give a poll here in the I button, and you have to answer that poll. And in poll, ABCD options are given. Here are the options, you have to choose only that option. And today's question is, the phenomena of creeping occurs in which one, ammeter, voltmeter, wattmeter, or energy meter? And solutions for the rest questions will be uploaded very soon on this channel and the playlist OPSC Assistant Executive Engineer Electrical Engineering 2015 Paper 2. And don't forget to comment regarding all these things, your doubts regarding any question or any solution I have done wrong, or any good idea you have in regarding any question, or how to develop video or audio quality, any suggestions you have. Or don't forget to like and share with your friends. Thank you.